I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream.
The greatest witness for freedom ever taken place, that has ever taken place on the steps of the capital of any state in the South. And this whole march adds drama to this total thrust. Last Sunday, more than 8,000 of us started on a mighty walk from Selma, Alabama. They told us we wouldn't get here. There were those who said that we would get here only over their dead bodies.
Martin Luther King Jr. wasn't American. He was deeply American. And what's striking to me is that he had more confidence and faith in American democracy, in the Constitution, and in the principles of fairness and opportunity than nearly all of his critics.
What was Martin Luther King Jr.'s message?
Martin Luther King Jr.'s message was one of unity and inclusion for all people, no matter what race, no matter who you are, no matter sexuality, religion. It's just basically saying, it's a fruition of what's said in our Constitution, that everyone is equal, that everyone can live together in one world that is unified.
To end racism and get people together.
To end racism without any violence.
I think his message was for all of us to be equal and, you know, treat each other with kindness.
How do you think Martin Luther King's message impacted our school?
I believe his message impacted our school in a multitude of ways. Around our school, I see so many people from different races, different backgrounds, ethnic backgrounds, that are able to be friends and love each other and be unified. And we have multiple clubs around our school that are, you know, they're focusing on one racial, like, background, but, like, still they include everybody. Everybody's included. Everybody can join. Everybody can be a part of it. So, yeah.
Every day at the lunch, just learning, the learning environment.
I mean, you see different races all around at school. It's not just white schools and then just black schools.
I think it makes us a very diverse community, and we get to learn a lot of other people's backgrounds.
I think the dilemma is much deeper, and I think one during this period of transition has to be very honest with America. And honesty impels me to admit that America has broad racist elements still alive. Racism is still existing in American society.
You know? Of course I know. Martin did things that changed this country and people's lives. He helped people understand that it was in their power to help change ideas and laws. Without Martin and the civil rights movement, who knows what would have happened?
But if Martin were only here now, we still need him so much.
People still have problems getting along, but it's much better today because of Martin Luther King Jr. I believe if we keep working on it, it'll only improve. So don't be sad, Miles. Martin will always be with you if you remember what he stood for and lived by.
King seems to be widely loved and respected today. It wasn't always that way. In 1966, just 2 years before he was killed, according to Gallup polls, two-thirds of Americans didn't approve of him or his work. All of this is a reminder that advocating for social change, pushing against the status quo, and fighting against those in positions of power doesn't mean you'll be popular when you're doing it. In fact, you might be vilified, just like King was. But attempting to build a better society has never been about being popular or well-liked. It's about trying to build the sort of world that we all deserve to live in, even if it means you won't get to see that world yourself. And King, more than anyone, he knew this.
This is the most important
and crucial period of your lives, for what you do now and what you decide now at this age may well determine which way your life shall go. And the question is whether you have a proper, a solid, and a sound blueprint. And I want to suggest some of the things that should be in your life's blueprint. You must have, as a basic principle, the determination to achieve excellence in your various fields of endeavor. You're going to be deciding as the days and the years unfold what you will do in life, what your life's work will be. Once you discover what it will be, set out to do it, and to do it well. Be a bush if you can't be a tree. If you can't be a highway, just be a trail. If you can't be the sun, be a star. For it isn't by size that you win or you fail. Be the best of whatever you are. Well, life for none of us has been a crystal staff, but we must keep moving. We must keep going. If you can't fly, run. If you can't run, walk. If you can't walk, crawl, but by all means, keep moving.
Revealed the tears that was on my face, yeah. Walk away from me.